Hi guys, it's your dietitian Audi Naana here again, and this week I'm coming to you with the nutrition tip. I am answering a question that came up from what I shared with you last week. So this week I want to talk about nutrition for the elderly, people who are extremely old. There are certain concerns that come up with the quality of their nutrition as such people go through life, and I want to touch on a few points today, and I hope they are helpful. The first thing is that as people age, the ability to chew really declines because the strength of their gums is not optimum. They lose some teeth and they are not able to chew meat or some other foods that require a lot of movement of the jaws. So for such people, you may think about pureeing their foods or preparing foods that are extremely soft. So you may go in for things like porridges, but you could also do things like mpoto mpoto, or do things like tzet, or very soft banku, or really soft kenke for them. Or when it's something like ampisi, you may want to consider mashing the yam and then adding it to the stew for them to take. Another thing also is that their gut movement is also reduced or slows down, so they are prone to having constipation. Another factor that affects this is that they are also not able to drink enough water. So for the elderly, you may want to look at using foods that are not refined or polished. So you want to add a lot of whole grains to their foods, and then foods with fiber generally, and adding soups and vegetables to the carbohydrates that they take so that the constipation is reduced significantly. You also want to encourage them to take in sips every now and then. So you may want to give them juices, water as they sit throughout the day, and you may also want to give them little bits of things that they can suckle on, not necessarily sweets, but you may want to freeze some fruit pieces, for example, so that they just suckle on these things as they go through the day. So I hope these tips are helpful. Now I want to point out again that you don't have to stop them from taking meat or fish just because they cannot chew. For a lot of them, there are nutritional concerns, so they may have been asked by their dietitians, for example, to avoid red meat if they have certain kinds of cancers and all that. But for most of them, when you take off the fat around the meat, they are okay with that. They should be able to take that. You can add eggs to their meals, for example. And you may also want to consider mashing or blending the fish or the chicken or whatever you are using into their meals for them, or using softer fishes like salmon and mackerel instead of the extremely dry and ones that are hard to chew, so that they are still getting the nutrition that they need. And a lot of us cut out fat completely from the diet of elderly people just because of their age. Now that is not the way to go. Rather, you want to switch to healthier sources of fat. So things like avocado, pear, things like nuts. You can form some nut puree, and then you add it to, for example, you spread their bread with peanut butter or granite paste, as we would call it. And all these things are helpful ways of helping them to get some good quality fats, so that things like dementia and others do not become debilitating for them. So I hope this week's tips have been helpful, and please share like always, and remember to follow me on Infine Fertile GH on Instagram and Facebook. We are on YouTube as well as IFF Wellness. Have a lovely day and stay blessed. Love you. Bye.